Hi, hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are going to solve this QuickStart Build a Service Agent with Agentforce. And the name of the challenge is Configure Agentforce for Service. Click on that. So, first of all, to start this challenge, we need to create a custom Agentforce playground. For that, click on this checkbox, I can receive a password reset email, and then click on this Create Playground button. So here we can see that we will send a password reset email when your playground is ready. So wait for some time to get your playground ready, and if it is ready, you will get the email. So keep checking your email. So after just waiting 3 to 5 minutes, I got this. We sent a password reset email to your email. So once open your email, and here the email looks like this. Finish resetting your Salesforce password. So click on this link and then click on this reset password. Now here set your own password and it should be of 8 characters. Then confirm the password. After that, type your answer for this security question. And then click on this change password button. So the password is resetted successfully. We need to connect this to that playground. So copy the username here. So this is your username. So copy and move to this instruction space, and here click on this connect playground button. Now paste the username which you copied and then type the password. Now click on this login button. Then click allow. And after here click on this as save it button. So the password reset is successfully and we successfully connected the org. So we need to launch. So for that, click on this launch button. And so here we can see that this playground will be expired after 5 days. So within 5 days only, you will need to complete this. So here is the playground. And from here, move to the setup page. Further, click on this gear icon. And here, click on this setup. So now we will start with the step-by-step instructions. So first of all, we need to move to the setup, and then in this quick find, search for Einstein setup. So move to the setup page, and in this quick find, search for Einstein setup. EinsteinSetup. So click on this Einstein setup, and here click on this turn on Einstein. So after turn on, just refresh the page. And then in this quick find, search for Agentforce agents. So here you can see that Agentforce agents button. Click on that. So here turn on this toggle. And then in this, enable the Agentforce default agent, turn on this. And after that, in this quick find, search for users. So click on this users. And then in this Einstein service agent user, click edit. So in this profile, change it to Einstein agent user and then click save. So after updating the user, again move to this quick find and now search for all sites. So click on this all sites, and then before this Coral Cloud, click on this builder. So click OK. And here click on this publish button. and then click publish. So it takes some time, so we will move with next instructions. And the next instruction is about creating a new agent. So move to this space, and in this quick find search for Agentforce agents again. So click on this Agentforce agents, and here click on this new agent. And here click on this agent for service agent. Then click next. After that, leave the topics and click next. Here, copy the name from the instructions, that is CC service agent, and then add it here. Also copy the API name, add it. And then copy the description, replace it with this description, and after that, copy the role. So replace it, and then copy the company. So just replace it. And after that, in this agent user, just remove this. And here, select this as Einstein Service Agent User. And then click on this checkbox near to this Keep a Record of Conversations. Then click Next. And finally, click on this Create button. So from this page, click on this drop down near to this account management, and then click on this remove from agent. So similarly, do that for all the topics here except this general FAQ. So before this case management, click on drop down and remove from agent, and delivery issues, click on drop down and remove from agent, and then escalation, click on drop down, remove from agent. And after this, order inquiries, click on drop down and remove from agent. And then reservation management, click on drop down, remove from agent. And finally, for this service customer verification, click on drop down and remove from agent. So after that, in this space, click on this new button and then click on this new topic. From here, click on this next button and then enter the name, copy from the instructions, that is experience management. So add it here and then copy the classification description. So add it here and then copy the scope, add it here. After that, so we need to add the instructions. So copy the instruction. So this is the first instruction. Add it here. And then click on this add instruction button. Now copy the second instruction. Add it. And then click on add instruction. Add the third instruction as well. And after that, click on add instruction. Now copy the fourth instruction and add it here. Again, click on add instruction and copy the fifth instruction. Add it. And again, click on add instruction and copy this sixth instruction. So like this, we need to add all the six instructions here. And after adding all the six instructions, click on this next button. And then click on this finish button. And after that, we can see that the experience management topic is added. And click on this experience management. And here, click on this topic's action. And after that, click on this new and click on this create new action. So for this reference action type, select it as flow. And then click next. So here we need to select the reference action also. So for that, select it as get experience details and then click next. So here uncheck this checkbox, show loading text for this action, and for this experience name select this require input, and for this experience record select this show in conversation, and after that click on this finish button. So we can see that your changes were saved successfully. Just refresh the page. So we will check that whether it is saved or not. So again click on this experience management and move to this topic actions. So we can see that get experience details were added successfully. And after that, we need to add an action to validate the customer details. So again move to this agent force builder, and again in this space just click on this new button and then click on this create new action, and from this reference action type select it as flow, and from this reference action select it as get customer details. So after that click on next. And here uncheck this show loading text, and from this email select it as require input, and for this contact select it as show in conversation, and for this member number select it as require input, and after that click finish. So you can see that your changes were saved successfully, and we got this get customer details also. Again we need to add another action, so click new and then click on this create new action. So here select the reference action type as flow and reference action as get sessions. So after that click this next button, and here deselect this show loading text for this action, and for this experience ID select it as require ID require input, and for this sessions select it as showing conversation, scroll down, and for this start date select it as require input, and finally click on this finish button. So another action is also added successfully. Then again click on this new button and then click on this create new action, and reference action select it as prompt template, and in this reference action select it as generate personalized schedule, and click on this next button, and here we need to add this agent action instruction. So copy from the instructions, so it is generate a personalized schedule, and then add it here, and also deselect this show loading test, and for this input my contact require input is selected, and we need to add these instructions. So copy and then add it here, and after that in this prompt response select it as show in conversation, and then click finish button. So another action is added. And after that we need to add another action, that is click new and then click on this create new action. For reference action type select it as flow, and reference action select it as create experience session booking, and then click next. Again deselect the show loading test, and here for contact ID select this require input, and for this booking select this show in conversation, and for this guest select this require input, and for this output message select this show in conversation, and finally for this session ID select this require input. And after selecting all of these click on this finish button. So we have created the five actions for this agent. So after that, click on this activate button. So we can see that your preview conditions were applied and your new session was started. So like this, the agent is created successfully. And also, so it is also we are publishing your changes now and you will receive an email message. So click on this got it button. And after that, so the next one we need to do is test the agent, and no need to do to complete this challenge. And this publish and update is also not important, so I am just moving to the next instructions. So the next instruction is reroute the flow. So for that, move to the setup page. So in this quick find, search for flows. So click on these flows. So in these flows, search for route to ESA. So select this route to ESA flow. So here it is. So click on this route to ESA. Then click on this route to ESA. Double click. Just dismiss and just scroll down, and here in this route to select it as agent service agent, and after that agent for service agent select it as CC service agent, and after that click on the save as new version and then click on the save button. So it is saving, and after that click on this activate button. So we can see that your automation was added activated successfully. And the next task is to add the AgentForce agent to the Coral Cloud site. And I think that it is not important. And also this view the agent is also not important. And it is up to you. If you want, you can do these also. Just scroll down to the last and then click on this verify step button. So yeah, we got this quick start build a service agent with AgentForce batch, and we completed this without any errors. And please do check out our channel Education Matters for next module answers, and also please do share our channel to your friends. It will help them too. That's it. Thank you.